Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, I'm going to show you how I created those bug and feedback buttons in one of my previous videos. Let's go. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. In one of my previous videos, I created a feedback and a bug button, and it had different actions. The big thing that was part of it that I think got most people was, how did you put an icon and the text in there at the same time and have the icon change colors with the text? How did you do that? In fact, there was a comment on that video from Bees Quick Fix Delicious Recipes that asked for a tutorial on how to do it. So enough of all this talking, you know, we like to do it here in Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. So here's the report that I actually showed, and you'll see here the report a bug and provide feedback. And you'll notice that the icon and the text and the border all change color together. In fact, there's three colors. The base color is this kind of grayish looking color. If I hover over it, I get a blue color. And if I click it, there's a black color. So there's actually three states as part of this. So how do we do it? Let's start with going to a blank page. Go to insert, we're gonna go to buttons, and I'm gonna do a blank button. Then the next thing I'm going to do is let's add the text. So let's go into style. So style is kind of where all of the items are. And you'll see here there's text. So let me go and add a text. We'll just do feedback. I'm going to end up with an icon on the left side, and I want my text on the right side. So I'm going to right align the text, and then we can bump this up. Let's say 14, make it bold, and maybe we'll add some padding here as well. So the padding is kind of like white space on this side, so it's not right up on the border. The other thing I'm going to do while I'm in here is I'm going to go to shape, and I'm going to change this to rounded rectangles. All of this is personal preference. The next thing I want to do is get my icon in. I found an SVG that is what I'm looking for. To be clear, the icon itself, it doesn't have to be an SVG. It can be a JPEG, it can be a GIF. The thing with SVGs is they scale properly, so that could benefit you without getting all fuzzy. Or typically with a JPEG or GIF, if you want it to scale right, you gotta have it a lot bigger, and then you can make it smaller and it'll still look good. But if you have a small image and you make it bigger, it'll not look great. So SVG will scale appropriately. So I just so happen to have one. So the next thing we need to do is come down to icon. You'll see icon is on. So if we go there, the icon type is blank. So we're gonna come here. You can do all sorts of different icons, right? I could do left arrow, and that's left aligned. So you can see already that we've got our arrow plus our text, right? But I want a custom icon. So let me go down to custom, and then we can browse for the files. And then you'll see here, I've actually got three different items, but let's just focus on the one. You'll see here, this is the icon that I had as part of it. Cool. So now I need to go in and I want a border. So we're going to turn border on and just go with the default. And there's our grayish look.
Nice.
So we're done. Well, not really yet. So we've just got one. Remember, I said there were three styles. Right now, we just have this grayish look. This is the default look. And you can tinker around with the spacing and the padding and trying to get it to look right and form it up with the space that you're going to put it in. So lots of tinkering can go into this to get it to look the way you want. That's all personal preference. So let me go into PowerPoint. And because it's an SVG, I can easily work with that. So let me just go ahead and drag this in. There's my feedback icon. And you'll see it's this default gray color. There's a lot of different programs you can do this with. You could do it with Photoshop. I actually did it with Adobe Illustrator because I got it as an EPS file and I pulled it out. But if you got Office, let's just use PowerPoint and do it. So if I select the image, I can actually change the graphic fill. You can pick whatever color you want. I actually have a hex code that I use for Guy in a Cube blue, and that's what I'm using here. Now, if you want the outer bubble to be a different color than the inner bubble, that's where you're gonna need to use another application. I don't know that you're gonna be able to do that inside of PowerPoint. Something like Adobe Illustrator, you can absolutely do that. So I got my blue, and then you can just right click and do save as picture, and then save it out as an SVG, right? And you're good to go. And then when I need the black, I'll just change it to black and save that out as well. So now we have our three icons. So let's go back to our report. So now what I wanna do is I wanna go back, select the button, and we're gonna go through on the style. You'll notice this apply settings too, and there's a state. So you have default, on hover, on press, and disabled. So in this case, I'm just gonna mess with default, on hover, and on press. I'm gonna ignore disabled. It's up to you on what you wanna do with your report. So let's change to on hover. So now everything I change here is gonna be in the context of on hover. So the text, the first thing I need to do is change the color. I'm gonna pick my Guy in a Cube blue, which happens to be right right here. So if we look, I hover, there it goes. Feedback is blue. All right, so that's the first part. The icon, I can't do color for the icon. There's nothing I can do here because I'm doing a custom image. So I'm gonna get rid of that and I'm gonna pull in my blue button. So now text and icon are going the same. And now I gotta do the border, same thing. Change the color. And that's how easy this is. So now the whole button is going. Everything's together as one. So now let's go through and do the on press. So on press text, we're gonna change the font color to black. Change the icon to black. And change the border. Just learning the clicks. That's it. That's all we're doing here. So now default gray. If I hover over it, it's blue. And if I press, it's black. So now we have our three states. That's bananas. There's two things that make this pop. One is on the buttons, you've got the different states. And then the second thing that makes this pop are the icon images for each color so that you can give that experience of it's a one holistic thing. And then you've got your icon and text button that changes colors based on the state. All right, I want to hand this over to you. What do you think? Did that blow your mind? Did you already know about how to do this with buttons? Did you learn something new? Let me know in the comments. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.